Mohammed?
Yeah.
Good morning, sir. How are you? Mike.
Hi.
Pleasure to meet you.
Good.
I'm going to understand we're here to do some boiler maintenance for you. Yeah, let me give you my card. I like giving out my cards. They're nice cards. How's your holidays treating us so far? End of the year. Good?
Good, yes.
You're getting better at finessing the map. Look at that.
Almost.
You almost had it. Please.
Would you like us to do today? Just general maintenance? You want to do a budget friendly one, more intensive, everything comes out?
Hi, or baby.
What would you like? Let me tell you the options.
You're scaring me.
What kind of problems are you having?
Just taking a long time to heat.
Like, taking a long time to heat?
And it constantly cycles, I think, in my opinion.
How long has that been going on for?
Since we got here.
Really?
Yeah.
And how old is the boiler?
Just like 1.5.
How long have you lived here?
A year and a half.
Yeah.
Oh.
Around there. A little
more. So you put the boiler in?
Yeah.
You put the boiler before you moved in?
After we moved.
After?
In. It was oil.
It was oil. You had oil heat before. Okay.
Yes, yes, yes.
So the whole house is, it takes a long time. Like, how long does it take for it to heat up?
An hour, maybe more, for 1 degree.
Okay. That's normal.
Really?
Yeah.
It felt a lot faster when
I
was oil.
Well, it could have also been an oversized boiler. That is possible, but I'm just based on what I see. It's not a tremendous big boiler. It's not a baby boiler either. You know, and your house is really not tremendous either. I mean, how many radiators do you have? 10, 12 radiators probably?
Eight.
Eight radiators. Yeah, there you go. All right, close. Right? I actually overshot that. And what temperature are you keeping the thermostat set to? Do you want
70.
Okay, and you have a programmable thermostat? Is it?
Yeah.
Okay, so
it's
what?
It's like this Nest.
The Nest. Uh-huh. Okay, you put the Nest in?
Well, we had somebody else.
Yeah, but you had it installed.
Yes.
Okay, gotcha. Okay, you know what's so special about the Nest?
It's Wi-Fi.
Well, that too, yeah. It's Wi-Fi, makes life easier because you could be anywhere in the world and control the heat or the thermostat, right?
Yeah.
But it also is a learning thermostat, right? So it learns your behavior. And it's great for like HVAC systems that include a forced air type of furnace or like a heat pump maybe, because the recovery rate or the time that it takes for the home to heat up with like air is much faster than like a boiler that heats with water. You actually heat with water, you know, it boils it until it creates steam, and then the steam travels in piping and then reaches the radiators. And then when the temperature is satisfied, those radiators stay hot for quite some time, right? So sometimes it even overshoots the heat. But, you know, and Nest is not, what I'm trying to say is that Nest is not the ideal thermostat for what the heating system that you have, right? So if there's any energy saving features in that thermostat, I would suggest you turn them off. And if there's not, you know, you may be best getting a different type of Wi-Fi thermostat. Maybe like an Eco B that allows you to have remote temperature sensors so you can like average temperature, you know, balancing out. Or maybe like a Honeywell 9000 if you still want a Wi-Fi thing. Those are great thermostats for what you have. But a Nest, you know, any reputable HVAC contractor is going to say, no, it's not for steam. But back to the issue here, you're having the for maintenance and or problems that you're having. We can, you know, check, you know, do what we normally do, you know, make sure that all the controls work, like the pressure control. But like I was saying when I first got here, there's two different options of service that we offer for steam. One is more of a budget-friendly option where we do a combustion test. We, you know, we check the pressure. We make sure the low water cutoff works. That is $225 plus your trip charge. More intense maintenance is where we take out like all the burners, we clean them, we lubricate them, we vacuum out the combustion chamber, we to remove the probe on the low water cutoff because it's an electronic one here, and we, you know, service everything. And that's $440 plus your trip charge. But for the problems that you're describing, it sounds like you just need to either, you know, deal with the Nest and its limitations for what the system that you have is, or get a different thermostat that would satisfy that. But also keep in mind that I don't know what you had before. All I know is you had oil, right? But I also know that we're in a very confined space with no makeup air. So regardless of the issues that you're having with it heating up this home, your home, is that there's not enough air for the water heater and the boiler to burn safely and properly. Okay. Keep that in mind. You have this 100, how many BTUs is this thing? 138,000 BTU gas boiler. And next to me is this A.O. Smith water heater, which is 40,000 BTUs. So that's, I know this may be gibberish to you, but you have 175,000 BTUs of gas being used potentially at the same time with a door, and this boiler room is always closed with a window that's just cracked open a little bit. You do not have enough fresh air for the flame to burn efficiently and properly, right? That window needs to be fully open, and maybe this one over here as well, or you need to bring in makeup air. Otherwise, soon, and I don't know what definition of soon is, but it could be in a couple of years from now, or maybe, you know, more than that. But eventually, you're going to cause irreparable harm to the equipment because it's starving for oxygen. Oxygen needs, flame needs oxygen to burn. So back to the number I was saying, that 175,000 BTUs of gas that these use when they're both running at the same time. Picture, I don't know, maybe 20,000 candles. Candles, regular candles.
But,
yeah, it's cracked open a little bit. Yeah, but it's not enough, right? That's nowhere near enough.
Okay.
If you fully open that window, then maybe it's half the amount of oxygen that this needs.
Some people say this, you don't open like inches or something like this, not too much.
In season?
One inch.
No, that's nowhere near enough.
Before I do like a 3 inch.
No, I would fully open that. I would actually remove all the glass there. Seriously, you don't have enough oxygen here. Like, that is just crack open. It's a little baby window. You don't have enough oxygen here. So imagine this. 20,000 candles burning in this room. Forget about what's in here right now. With the door closed. What's going to happen? Yeah, it's going to get very hot. Yeah, that's the most common answer, right? It gets very hot, right? No, but the flame is going to extinguish itself because it's not enough oxygen for all those candles to burn properly. And they'll all get dim. Very, very dim. Just keep that in mind.
Okay.
Any questions so far? Okay, what would you like me to do today? And by the way, you also offer maintenance plans as well. So we come here once a year and do a tune-up on the boiler. We take everything out. And we basically do that more expensive plan. We do it once a year. So we have maintenance plans like that. So it could help, so it's not so expensive. You're paying it over 12 months because it's a plan that's billed monthly.
And maintenance plans,
how much is that?
That is approximately like $38 a month.
$38.
Approximately, yeah. Plus tax and things like that, yeah. So the way the maintenance plan works is, the system automatically charges a debit or credit card, whatever that fee is. I think it's like $38 a month, whatever, plus tax. And we come here. It's a 1 year minimum commitment, so you have to agree to 12 months minimum. You're locked into that rate forever until your card cancels or until you cancel the plan or it declines. And we come here once a year and we do that extensive, maintenance, a deep cleaning. You also get emergency service included and no trip charges. And you also get a discount on repair. So let's say hypothetically, 6 months from now or 2 years from now, you have this plan and a part breaks, right? You're not going to pay a trip charge. You're going to pay a discount on labor and you're going to pay a discount on that part you need. But you're also getting, you're basically paying for a discounted tune-up over a period of 12 months. So just giving you information of what we also offer.
Okay.
Let's do this almost right now. You go to the cleaner.
And from what I found, the pressure goes up to like 5 and beyond sometimes.
On the pressure gauge?
Yeah.
All right. And that's helpful. So you need some service and cleaning on this thing.
Let's say it works for 20 minutes. Turns on, turns off. Well, for like a minute. Turns back on.
On off, on off, on off, on off.
On off.
Okay. So that may be a pressure control issue. Do you ever notice the light on the low water cutoff, which is on the opposite side, turn on, or the water level?
I never checked that.
Okay.
2 weeks ago, and this thing kept going off. So.
Which thing?
That.
The feeder?
Yeah. What? Every 2 days until some guy came in, he replaced a valve, like an air valve on a vent.
Oh, you were losing water.
Yeah.
Yeah. Continuously, yes.
One of them still does it. But...
Yeah. Yeah. So those little silver things, they usually are silver on each radiator. If they hiss continuously, that's no good because that means it's
coming like once a day.
Yeah. Well, once a day is that's no good. Once a month, right? So if your automatic feeder is turning on once a day, that's a problem. Think about where that water is going.
Not even once, like a week or something,
sometime. Because he just said like every day.
Every 2 days.
And every 2 days, and now he's saying once a week.
That was like 2 weeks ago, so he replaced
Okay.
Yeah.
And that's what that you hear of. Someone always home?
No.
Yeah, so. Just saying. Okay, or you just want to pay me for my trip charges. Your call, it doesn't matter to me.
Talk to yourself. I'm a dead man.
I'm not that lucky. The guarantee now.
He wants to know if you can give a guarantee if you can find a problem, like if there is a problem.
Well, if you're seeing the pressure gauge go to 5,
or near 5, yeah,
that's a problem. Either the gauge is not correct, or there's something wrong with the pressure control, or the pressure control is not sensing pressure. That's a problem. It should not be a 5 psi. Right, or close to that. It's a low pressure boiler. It should be like half a PSI, where that gauge does not even register any pressure at all because it's not that type of heating system. But, you know, you have these pressure controls on boilers that, you know, when ones don't understand steam, they think, to solve any problem of the boiler not heating the house fast enough or all the radiators getting hot enough or all of them getting hot at all, you people think that you can raise the pressure on the pressure control to give you more steam. Yes, you'll have more steam and more pressure. But that's not the answer, right? So as far as guarantee, listen, you have a steam heating system. It's not like I could just wave a magic wand and 5 minutes later, tell you A, B, and C is what's wrong here, right? You have a steam heating system that's improperly installed, right? And I didn't even get to that yet. And nothing here is insulated. And what I mean by improperly installed, I think Derek will probably point it out right away. You have this equalizer line right here, which shall not be one pipe size smaller than the pipe it's connected to. This is a 2-inch pipe. This is a 1-inch pipe. The maximum that this pipe could be is inch. I'm sorry. The minimum size that this pipe could be, since this is 2-inch, is inch and a half, but it's 1-inch, right? So when you talk about having steam issues, right, you have to look at everything as a whole. So we'll fix. I don't even know what your problem is. You tell me it takes a long time for the home to heat up. Yes, maybe yes, maybe yes, maybe no, maybe just the way it is. Now that you have a proper. I don't even know if I have a properly sized boiler. So it's not like I could spend 15 minutes here and solve the problem. I don't know what was here before. I don't know the size of each radiator. I know you said you have 8 radiators, but I don't know the size of each radiator. I don't know if any of the piping still is insulated. Here, nothing is insulated. So that means it wasn't done with a permit, right? Because if it was done with a permit, everything here would be insulated to code, right? And it's not. And this would have been caught, right? So it's not. So you're looking for a guarantee. I can't offer a guarantee unless we spend a lot more time here that you're not going to get with a 15-minute trip charge. But I can tell you this, that besides the pressure, being 5 PSI, that could be multiple things. But I'm just, I can see the obvious things that are wrong here. And lack of insulation, improper size equalizer. Just to name a few. And also, like this, the way they even put in this zone here at the bottom of the boiler with the circulator and this half inch PEX, it's just, you have it on that side too. It's just, it's whatever. It is what it is. But I don't know. Hopefully you got a good price on it.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. I was looking at the timer on the video while I was taking video, and I noticed that it said 15 minutes. So at that point, I don't know if I got that on video or not, but I said, okay, your 15 minutes is up. How would you like to proceed? And they're like, okay, we'll think about it. I'm like, okay, you think about how you want to take care of your boiler and the heating system that you have. But I think this interaction that I had with the homeowner is just reinforces the transparency and just the keeping it real with the homeowner, right? We listened to what their problem was. We gave them feedback on that, which you guys can't dispute our facts. And gave them ways on how we can proceed. I gave them ways on how you proceed right away, because I was dispatched for maintenance. But of course, it's never a maintenance. It's always something that's wrong, because people don't want to take care of their mechanical systems out of sight, out of mind. But that's why I offered the maintenance plan for our steam heating system that we offer our clients. And then offered a budget-friendly maintenance where we're there for about a little under an hour. And then a more comprehensive one with Derek and I could bang out in about an hour and a half. But they didn't want to do neither one of those. And if any of you guys could translate what they were saying in the between themselves, let me get that feedback in the comment section down below. All right, guys, we're heading to our next service call. Catch you in the next one. Be well. God bless. Stay safe. Make sure you smash that thumbs up button. Stop messing around and subscribe as well.